In this video, we'll talk about the limitations of cross-site HTTP requests, as well as the need for cross-site origin resource sharing, and how to set this up in the PyWeb API. First, what are cross-site HTTP requests? When a client makes a request to the PyWeb API service, and the client and the PyWeb API are on different domains, this is considered a cross-origin request. These requests are blocked by default. This is where cross-origin resource sharing comes into play, or CORS. The PyWeb API server has a set of configurational parameters which specifies the URLs, methods, and headers that are allowed to be requested from/by a cross-origin resource. Within CORS, there are two types of requests. Simple requests, which use get, head, or post, and no custom headers. All other requests are considered complex requests. While simple requests are what we would expect when you submit a request, it's directly to the server. Complex requests require you to make two requests, a pre-flight request and the actual request. The pre-flight request is one that asks the server if the methods, headers, and URL are supported or allowed. Let's illustrate this with an example. I have a simple web page with some JavaScript which queries the PyWeb API for the list of AF databases via an AJAX call made by jQuery. When a user clicks on this button from the HTML page, it will query the PyWeb API for the AF databases. As you can see, when we click on this button, the databases are not returned. When we open up Chrome Developer Tools, we can see all of the requests going on behind the scenes. In the console, we can see that we're getting an error, a no access control allow origin header. This is because I'm hosting the web page locally, but the PyWeb API is on the domain, so the request is blocked for security reasons. Under the Network tab, if we make the request again, we can see each of the individual pieces of the request here. We can see that it's a GET request, and that our origin is localhost. To fix this issue, we're going to go into the PyWeb API configuration database and take a look at the attributes. We can see that there are a number of attributes that are related to CORS. These are the parameters that the PyWeb API service checks against to see if our request is from a different domain is allowed. We need to make a few changes to allow our JavaScript application to get information from the PyWeb API service. We'll need to ensure the origin is listed here as part of the CORS origins. Since we're making a GET request, the method we know is already allowed. Let's check this in. And go back to our web page. The PyWeb API checks the AF configuration once every 15 seconds or so. Thus, if we wait about 15 seconds, after checking in the changes, we should be able to try this request again and have it succeed. This time, we see that the access control allow credentials header in the response must be set to true. Let's go back to our CORS attributes. As we can see here, the CORS supports credentials is set to false. Let's change this to true. Check in that change. And try this once again. and now we can see our two AF databases being populated. In this video, we talked about cross-site HTTP requests, as well as the need for cross-site origin resource sharing, and how to set this up in the PyWeb API. We demonstrated that when a client makes a request to the PyWeb API service from a different domain, that this would be considered a cross-origin request and is subjected to CORS validation parameters. We demonstrated that these requests are blocked by default, and that the PyWeb API service has a set of configurational parameters which specify which URLs, methods, and headers are allowed to be requested by the cross-origin resource.